Good morning, students. Today I am going to discuss about the questions that is based on previous video. Question number one, computers are used in hospital to perform lab test and prepare reports. Second, computers are used to forecast weather. Next question, what are the things that can be designed using a computer? Answer, car, aeroplane, and other machines. How is the computer useful in the bank? It is used to store information about customers, to take out money from an ATM, and to deposit and withdraw money from the account. So students, today I'm going to teach you parts of a computer system. In this session, I will discuss about data and information, input process output model, then input output devices, internal hardware, communication bus and ports. First, I will start from input process output cycle. Before we discuss this topic, I want to discuss about what is data and information. First, I will discuss about what is data and information. Computer data is information processed or stored by a computer. This information may be in the form of text, documents, images, audio chips, software programs, or other types of data. Computer data may be processed by computer CPU and is stored in files and folders on the computer's hard disk. Data can be defined as a representation of facts, concepts, or instructions in a formalized manner, which should be suitable for communication, interpretation, or processing by human or electronic machine. Data is represented with the help of characters such as alphabets, digits, or special characters. Information. Information is organized or classified data which has some meaningful values for the receiver. Information is the processed data on which decisions and actions are based. For the decision to be meaningful, the processed data must qualify for the following characteristics. timely. Information should be available when required. Accuracy. Information should be accurate. Completeness. Information should be complete. Then I will discuss about what is input. Input means various input devices like a keyboard, mouse, etc. are used to enter the raw data into the computer for processing and then stored in storage devices. Process in this step, the input data is processed according to a set of instructions given to a processor to get the required output. That is the information. Output. The processed data is sent back to the user through different output devices like a monitor, printer, speaker, etc. The instructions and data are stored in the computer's memory. Thus, we can say that data processing requires an input device, a processing device, memory to store data, and an output device. These components are collectively known as computer hardware. Next, what is the difference between data and information? Information is a processed, organized data presented in a given context and is useful to humans. Data is an individual unit that contains raw material which does not carry any specific meaning. Information is measured in meaningful units like time, quantity, etc. All modern computers function on the same general model of input, process, and output. A computer receives an input, processes the information, then performs an output. Input means type in the message and press send. Process means the phone's hardware and network process the message. Output means the message goes to the receiver. Now I will discuss about what is input device. In computing, an input device is a piece of equipment used to provide data and control signals to an information processing system such as a computer or information appliance. Examples of input devices include keyboards, mouse, scanners, digital cameras, joysticks, and microphones. Computer keyboard. A computer keyboard is one of the primary input devices used with a computer, similar to an electric typewriter. A keyboard is composed of buttons that create letters, numbers, and symbols as well as perform other functions. In this picture, you can see there are different types of keys, functions keys, control keys, numlock key, caps lock key, and scroll lock indicators, alphabet key, numbers key. The alphabet keys are arranged in a special order called the QWERTY format. There are usually 104 to 108 keys on a standard Windows keyboard. The keys on a standard keyboard can be divided into the number keys, alphabet keys, control keys, function keys, and special keys based on their functions. On pressing a key, a unique set of binary code is generated and sent to the computer. Next, computer mouse. A computer mouse is a handheld pointing device that detects two-dimensional motion relative to a surface. This motion is typically translated into the motion of a pointer on a display, which allows a smooth control of the graphical user interface of a computer. It is a small object which can be moved over a flat surface, preferably a mouse pad. When it moves, a graphic arrow head called the pointer moves on the screen. It is used for selecting any object on the screen. It has a left and right button for selecting along with a scroll wheel in the center, which is used to move a page up and down. So there are different types of mouse, like the commonly used mechanical mouse, which uses a ball and roller system, or the optical mouse, which uses an LED light source and sensor. Examples of manual input devices: keyboard, numeric keypad, pointing device, remote control, joystick, touch screen, scanner, graphics tablet, microphone, digital camera, webcams, light pens. Next, I will discuss about central processing unit. CPU is considered as the brain of the computer. CPU performs all types of data processing operations. It stores data, intermediate results, and instructions, or you can say program. It controls the operation of all parts of the computer. The CPU consists of three components: the ALU, CU, and the memory unit. Arithmetic logic unit. It performs all arithmetic calculations, like as addition, subtraction, multiplication, and division. It also takes care of all logical comparisons. Control unit. It uses electrical signals to instruct the whole computer system for carrying out or executing the instructions. It controls and coordinates all the components of the computer. It fetches instructions from memory, decodes and executes them. It regulates the flow of information through the processor. It communicates with both the memory unit and the ALU, means arithmetic logic unit. Next, storage unit. The storage unit is a fundamental component of the computer. The central processing unit of a computer manipulates the data by performing computations. The data which is to be processed and the instructions to process the data are stored here. The output is also stored here. Next, output devices. Computer output devices receive information from the computer and carry data that has been processed by the computer to the user. It converts the information which is in electronic form into human readable form. Depending upon requirement, different devices are used for the purpose. So here you can see different types of output devices like monitors, printers, speakers, headphones, sound cards, plotters and projectors. Computer hardware includes the physical parts of a computer such as the case, central processing unit, monitor, mouse, keyboard, computer data storage, graphics card, sound card, speakers and motherboard. Here I want to discuss about some internal hardware devices like motherboard. Most of the internal components of a computer are housed in the motherboard, which is a printed circuit board. These include the central processing unit, the memory cards and the sound, graphics and video cards. It also contains the ports. Expansion card. An expansion card is a circuit board that can be attached to a motherboard to add features such as video display and audio capability to your computer. Expansion cards are also called expansion boards. Next, graphics card. The graphics components are placed on a separate card which fits into a slot on the motherboard. They control and enhance how graphics, means pictures, videos, programs, animation or 3D are displayed on your computer screen. Sound card. A sound card is another expansion card or IC for producing sound on a computer which can be heard through speakers or headphones. They are also known as an audio output device, soundboard or audio card. They may also be built in on the motherboard. Next, communication bus and ports. The bus connecting the CPU and memory is one of the defining characteristics of the system and often referred to simply as the system bus. It is possible to allow peripheral to communicate with memory in the same fashion. Attaching adapters in the form of expansion cards directly to the system bus. The communication bus transfer data between components inside a computer or between two computers. Now I will talk about ports, cables and ports. Ports are slots on the motherboard into which a cable of an external device is plugged in. Mouse, keyboard, monitor, microphone, speakers, etc. are examples of external devices attached to the CPU cabinet via ports. Ports are of different types. You can see here different types of ports. Homework for today is, there are two fill in the blanks. Next question is, name any two output devices and specify where they are used. What do you understand by IPO cycle? Name any two input devices and specify where they are used. How is the serial port is different from parallel port? Thank you.